This is Emmy. I am back with a pretty highly requested video. A lot of people were asking for me to share my stats and extracurriculars. I definitely watched a lot of them when I was applying to college, so hopefully this can help some of you gain some insight into the college app process. Before I begin, I do want to make a little disclaimer. So this is just my personal path through the college app process. I'm just one person who was admitted to Princeton and MIT. There are like thousands of other people who are admitted to top schools. They all have different interests, different talents. So this is just my personal application. Okay, so I'm gonna get started with stats. I took the SAT twice in my junior year, once in August and once in December. I got a 1550 the first time and then a 1600 the second time. I didn't really do any new preparation between the two times I took the test, but my score still increased by 50 points. So that just goes to show that the SAT is just you sitting down on one single day and taking one single test. And it's not really representative of your abilities. In terms of SAT subject tests, I took two. I did math level 2 in freshman year. I got an 800. And then I also took SAT physics in August before my senior year, and I got an 800 on that as well. My school does not allow us to take APs in freshman year. So in sophomore year, I took 4, and these were AP NSL, Calc BC, Computer Science A, and Physics C Mechanics. So I got 5s on all of them, and I took classes for the first 3 and then self-studied Physics C Mechanics. In junior year, I also took 4 APs, and these were Stat, English, Language, Microeconomics, and World History. So I got 5s on all of them except for World History, which I got a 4 on. So now I'll move on to classes. So just for some context, I go to a public high school in Maryland, and I attend a STEM magnet program within my high school. So that means I take a bunch of specialized classes in math, science, and computer science. So one thing to know is that colleges are looking at you within the context of your high school. So it really depends on what classes you have available. Okay, so I'm just gonna list my classes over here. In freshman year, I took magnet functions. So that's our kind of combined version of pre-calculus and algebra 2. I did 1 semester of physics, 1 semester of chemistry, fundamentals of computer science, research and experimentation, which is kind of a wood shop kind of class. I also took honors US history, honors English 9, honors French 3, and chamber orchestra. In sophomore year, I took magnet analysis, which is the magnet version of AP Calc BC. I took biology, algorithms and data structures, which is kind of equivalent to AP Computer Science A. I did 1 semester of Earth Space Science, 1 semester of Principles of Engineering. I took Honors French 4, Honors English 10, AP NSL, and Journalism. Hey guys, so I had this video all edited and ready to post. So I was watching it back and I realized I accidentally deleted the part where I was talking about my junior year classes. So I'm just going to read them off real quick. For my school, junior year is where we start to take more of the magnet electives, and these are typically 1 semester long. So I'm gonna list my first and second semester schedules separately because I took completely different classes. So in the first semester, I took Applied Stat, which prepared me for the AP Stat exam, Biochemistry, Multivariable Calculus, Principles of Engineering, Analysis of Algorithms, AP World, AP Lang, and Newspaper. For second semester, I took Linear Algebra, Differential Equations, Quantum Physics, AP World, AP Micro, AP Lang, and Newspaper. Oh, and Senior Research Project A. So basically, in the magnet program at my school, in the summer between junior and senior year, we're supposed to do a research project in any field that we want, typically STEM. So mine was in math, and I think I talk more about the class
in the video. So
we take a class that kind of teaches us how to look at related literature, you know, get in touch with research mentors and be prepared to work in like a professional environment. Okay, in senior year, first semester, I took the second semester of the research project class. I took newspaper, AP Lit, yoga, computational methods, logic, which is kind of history of math, and mathematical physics. So math phys is similar to AP Physics C, except it's a little more advanced in terms of the math that we use. And it's also a double period class. So one class period, we have instruction, and the second period is meant for us to collaborate with our classmates on problem sets. So second semester, I have math phys, newspaper, AP Lit, yoga, and then my semester classes were discrete math, complex analysis, and comparative religions. So overall, I had a 4.0 unweighted GPA and then a 4.84 weighted GPA at the time that I was applying to college. In general, I would say colleges want to see that you've taken challenging classes in high school, so they know that you're prepared to take on more rigorous coursework in college. That being said, like, if you're a math major, you don't necessarily have to take the AP English classes. So take whatever works for you personally, but I would recommend taking the hard classes if you can handle it. Okay, so moving on to extracurriculars. So for the common application, which most schools use, you're allowed to list up to 10 activities. For the MIT application, they have their own set of questions, and they only allow you to report 4 activities, so it's a bit different. I can make a separate video talking about the MIT app in more detail if you guys want, but right now I'm just gonna read off the activities I listed on the Common app. So the first activity I have is math team. So I was in that for all 4 years of high school, and I was a captain in my junior and senior years. We participate in a bunch of local and national competitions. We also organize a student-run math competition for middle school students every year. So that's always one of my favorite experiences. So we write the problems, we get sponsors and funding. We kind of plan everything. So for me, I would say math team was one of the most meaningful activities that I participated in high school. And the order that I list the activities on my application kind of reflect that time commitment and passion that I had for these different activities. Second activity I had listed is integrals. So I was a co-founder and problem writing chair. So this is something I started with a bunch of my really close friends in January of my junior year. We organized a math competition for middle school and high school girls in the DC metro region. And I made a video about that on my channel last year, so you guys can go check that out. So since then, we've tried to expand it nationally and start locations for competitions across the country. Okay, the third activity I have is being editor-in-chief of my school's online student newspaper. So as you might have been able to tell from my classes, I took journalism in sophomore year, and that's a kind of requirement to be on the newspaper staff at my school. So as a junior, I was a staff writer, so I covered events and people that relate to my school and community. And then in senior year, I was EIC. So I oversee the staff, I edit and grade articles, mentor the writers, and kind of manage the classroom activities because newspaper is a class at my school. So activity number 4 is creative writing. So I write a lot of poetry, some nonfiction essays. This is something I did for all 4 years. So I was published in 24 online or print magazines. I also won a few awards regionally, nationally, and internationally. So activity number 5 was
being a research affiliate at the University of Maryland. So this is what I did for my senior research project. I was working with a math professor at UMD. So I was using computer programming to kind of model conservation laws, and I was working with partial differential equations. So that was something I did throughout junior and senior year. So activity number six, I was a violist in the Maryland Classic Youth Orchestras for all 4 years. So we have weekly rehearsals. We perform 4 to 5 concerts a year. Next activity I have was founding a Java programming class for local middle school girls. So I wrote lesson plans. I came up with games and demonstrations. So this was a weekly class at a public library, and it was a lot of fun for me. So that took place in my junior and senior year. Number eight is Math Honor Society. So this was also something I did all 4 years of high school. And then I was an officer for my junior and senior year. So in my description, I wrote that I increased membership from 30 to 90 people. Between my sophomore and senior years. I help members work on their peer tutoring strategies. We organize our school's Pi Day activities. And then this year we actually started a STEM night for local elementary school students. That was pretty cool. We organized a bunch of activities and got some funding from the school. So number nine, I was EIC of an online literary magazine. So my sister started that when she was in high school. And when she went off to college, I took over. After becoming EIC, I started a podcast that would go with our quarterly issues. And then I also started a poetry contest. Okay, so for my 10th activity, I volunteered at a senior retirement home really close to my house. So, oh, I forgot to mention I did Minute Magazine for my sophomore, junior, and senior year. And then for volunteering at the retirement home, I did that all 4 years over the summers. So that was kind of planning different activities for the residents. I also taught a class on how to use phones and laptops for the residents. So those were the 10 activities I listed on my Common App application. Okay, in terms of advice for extracurriculars, don't worry about what looks good on your resume or what you think college admission officers will like. In freshman year, I recommend joining a lot of clubs and figuring out what you actually want to dedicate a lot of your time to, and then focusing on those activities in particular. I firmly believe that if you have like passion, drive, and truly enjoy what you're doing, you'll be able to create an impact in the way that colleges will be impressed by. The activities that I was involved in were really math, writing, and community service. I did not do things like sports or debate, mock trial, DECA. I was mostly participating in kind of academic clubs and activities. So that just goes to show that it doesn't really matter which clubs you do, but how you're able to create an impact within those clubs. And that kind of ties in with doing what you're actually passionate about, because if you really enjoy what you're doing, you'll naturally want to improve it, expand what you're doing in some way, and that makes it a lot easier for you to show your initiative and leadership. So in terms of creating an impact, you don't necessarily have to start a new club. So you could increase your club's membership like I did for Math Honor Society. You could start a new initiative within your club, start a new fundraiser, things like that. And also doing things you actually enjoy is helpful when the time comes to write your college essays, because you can talk about things that genuinely excite you, and that excitement will definitely show through to people reading your essays. To conclude this video, I just want to reiterate that this is all my application. Hopefully you guys gained some insight into what I did in high school and I guess how I got into Princeton and MIT. If you guys have any further questions, feel free to email me or DM me on Instagram. And if there are other videos you would like to see from me, feel free to comment them down below. So one last thing before I end this video is that I have committed to college. So a couple days ago, I committed to Princeton and I'm planning to study mathematics there in the fall. So I will definitely be making more videos there next year, and I'm really excited to see where the next 4 years take me. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video.